Everyone in this arena has a money stake in one of our famous couples as we play the game of celebrity gossip, Tattletale. And here's the star of Tattletale, Kurt Conby.
Thank you, everybody. And welcome. I thank you. Hello. Hi, everybody. Welcome to Tattletales. Thank you for tuning us in. It's nice of you to do that. We appreciate it. You know, a lot lately I've been on the road and people keep asking me, and I forget to say it because we haven't said it for a long time. And let me very briefly just tell you what we do here. We have an audience divided into three sections, blue, banana, and red. They win the money as soon as their celebrity couples get the answer correct. And even if they don't get the big jackpot at the end of the show, they get the $200-$300 that their couple earns, okay? Because a lot of people ask me, what happens to that other money? Now, today, we have a special treat because we have a couple of MCs that you all know and love from other shows, and also some rookies with us, and here they are. Winning money today for the blue section. There he is, Mr. Bill Cullen and his wife, Ann.
Thank you. Thank you. Yeah.
Winning money today for the banana section, Mr. Bob Barker and his wife, Dorothy Jo. And winning money for the red section today, Larry Stewart and his wife from Days of Our Lives, Patty Weaver.
Yeah. All right, let's go.
Well, gentlemen, listen, you know, pardon me for a moment, Larry, because it is a little... Well, it's not nerve-wracking, but to look into your two faces is just, that's a little strange, you know what I mean?
This is the first time we've met.
What?
No, in all the years we've both been in television, it's the first time we've met.
That's right. We keep sending regards. I say, give Bob my regards. And he came back and said, I gave him your regards, he sends his back. But we finally met.
I want my regards back now that we got here.
Listen, you think he's going to make it in our business?
I don't know. He's a nice-looking fellow.
Yeah, but that's not everything.
Oh, I mean, I know that. I can read sometimes, but not all the time. Okay, listen, it's nice to have you both, and I hope you two get acquainted for the next few days. And Larry and Patty, welcome. It's your first time
Thank
with
you.
Us. You'll find out all about this in just a moment. Here comes the first question. Ann and Dorothy Jo, you know what this is about. It's worth $150 to your rooting sections, and this is it. Ladies, what would you say is the major ingredient in your charm? The little girl quality or the sophisticated lady quality? What is the major ingredient in your charm? Good question. Off you go. Now this, of course, you have a probably as good an opinion as they do of themselves. Bill, what do you think Ann will say?
Well, I'll tell you. The little girl quality no longer appeals to me because once that got me in trouble.
Uh-huh.
Years, you probably know, Bob. I mean, it's happened.
No, not.
It hasn't happened to you, Bob, huh?
Don't include
Larry,
me in
yeah,
your
right,
mess.
Hold it. That's probably because you...
Larry in San Francisco, I know. But anyway,
yes.
In all truth, it's a sophisticated lady. I mean, every time I see Ann, I hear that song. You know, sophisticated lady is definitely that.
Yes, there's a new one, I think, now. Sophisticated Lady. There's a new one with the same title.
A new one of the...
Yeah, isn't that right? Did you know that one? Yeah, sure they did.
It's about time.
But it's Sophisticated Lady. It's about time. Here she comes. And what would you say is the major ingredient in your charm? The little girl quality or the sophisticated lady quality?
I have neither one. I'll guess that Bill said sophisticated.
That's
You're right. Good.
Well, you do too have it. You're absolutely right, and how can you say you have neither one? There you are, as sophisticated and beautiful as you can be.
Oh, well, you're anyway. Sweet. I love you.
Bob, what will Dorothy Jo say?
Well, Dorothy Jo and I were high school sweethearts, and I certainly fell in love with her little girl qualities, you see. But I think she's going to say the same thing Ann said. I'm afraid she's going to say that she has neither. But... she will maintain that she lost her little girl qualities at about age 7.
Wow.
And
that's starting
and
early,
that,
isn't it?
And boy, say boy. That I said sophisticated lady.
You'll say sophisticated
yes,
lady.
Yes, I'll say that.
Bill
age
and I
seven,
are two minds with but a single thought.
Age
Here
7,
comes,
yeah.
Age 7, wow. Start them young, wherever they're from. Here comes Dorothy Jo. Dorothy Jo, what would you say is the major ingredient of your charm, the little girl quality or the sophisticated lady quality?
Is that all the alternatives?
That's all I've got, darling.
Well, then I guess I've got to say sophisticated.
That's the one. You got it.
All
Thank you, Dorothy Jo. Larry, what will Patty say?
All right, we're coming to our first little girl.
Uh-huh.
For the show, absolutely. Every time Patty tries to be sophisticated, she trips or spills tea. I mean, there's no... Plus the fact she's 5 foot tall, and to give you an example of the little girl quality, her nickname is Porky. Porky. So how can you be sophisticated with Nick? Ladies and gentlemen, Queen Porky, right? There's no way. It's going to be little girl.
She's 5 feet tall? She's only 5 feet?
5 feet, yeah.
Really? And you call her Porky?
Mm-hmm.
Gee, that doesn't sound like a nice thing to do, does it?
No, no. A term of endearment. Really.
What?
A term of endearment.
Oh, it is a term. Oh, yeah. Yes. That's what I got to do with my wife. Come here, you little Porky. Come here. Boom! Be over fast. Here she comes. Patty, what would you say is the major ingredient in your charm? The little girl quality or the sophisticated lady quality?
Without a doubt, it has to be the little girl quality.
That's the one. You got it. Everybody got that. That was a snap for you. We'll split that three ways. We'll come back in a moment with question number two and split a whole lot more. Got a wonderful group today. Don't miss it.
Inquisition. Sunday at 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific on Game Show Network.
This is the face of erectile dysfunction. So is this. And this. Fact is, one in three men have some form of ED, a medical condition also called impotence that affects men of every age, race, and background. What else do all these men have in common? They all faced up to their problem and got help. If you're experiencing ED, there's no need to hide your face. Just talk to your doctor. It's the best way to get educated about ED and how to treat it.
Who's the silliest bear around?
It's Singin' Eagle Poo. He sings.
When I'm up, down, touch the ground.
Tickle him, and he giggles while he sings.
I improve my appetite.
It's so much friendlier. Singin' Eagle Poo and friends.
At Burger King, we're making breakfast that's easy to eat on the run, like our sausage, egg, and cheese croissant sandwich or delicious French toast sticks. Grab them and go right now for just 99 cents each. Hey, with tasty choices like this, getting out of bed just got a whole lot easier.
Burger King, have it your way.
The wonderful thing about Tiggers is Tigger the wonderful things.
Your kids will love the Talkin' Tigger Bounce game.
Let's play.
Tigger has tons to say.
Tell us who you found.
Tickle it.
Fun, 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 fun.
Look for Talkin' Tigger Bounce game in the game aisle.
Chevy trucks are the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. And now, during Chevy Truck Month, you can get the authentic Chevy Tahoe with more standard horsepower and torque than Ford Expedition. Standard four-wheel anti-lock brakes and $1,000 cash back. During Chevy Truck Month, you'll find the biggest selection of the year on the most dependable, longest-lasting trucks on the road. Chevy trucks.
Mr. Right, Mr. Wonderful.
If they only knew.
All new Three's a Crowd. Find out who knows you best beginning November 29th only on Game Show Network.
We're on. Okay, here we go. Question number two coming up. This is it. If you are ready, we have a three-way tie, which is, I think, a nice way to begin, don't you, ladies? Mm.
Yes.
Which do you consider more romantic? Moonlight, candlelight, firelight, or no light at all? Think it over, ladies, and we'll find out. Hey, that's a good question, Bob. What do you think? Moonlight, candlelight, firelight, or no light at all?
I think that Dorothy Jo will probably say candlelight. We have eaten by candlelight, had dinner by candlelight, ever since we've been married. And the reason was that when we were first married, she made an apple pie.
Yeah.
And it was very good-tasting pie, but it was black.
Yeah.
It was, and so we ate by candlelight so that I couldn't see the pie. But after dinner, I was wondering why I had black all over my face. Not really, but she did. She made a mess of the apple pie, and I say candlelight.
And it became a tradition.
It's
because ever since then, you've been afraid to look at her dinner, so you've had
it right.
By candlelight. Okay, you'll say candlelight when she comes. Dorothy Jo, which do you consider more romantic, moonlight, candlelight, firelight, or no light at all?
I'd be willing to bet that Barker told you the story about me burning the pie. Did he?
Well, I'm not going to tell you yet.
Well, so it would have to be candlelight.
That's the one. You got it. And he did.
He's a big fan of yours. I listen to me. Yeah, that's true.
Absolutely correct. And we did get the pie story. Right on the button. Larry, what will Patty say?
Well, all four of them are dynamite with Patty, I have to tell you.
Oh.
But I think Patty will...
Dynamite's not on my card, Larry. It's just moonlight and candlelight.
Yeah, Patty is definitely a candle freak.
Oh.
And we light candles at every opportunity, even for breakfast or at noon, right? It's constantly lighting candles.
Oh, I see.
Yes.
Okay.
She's a worse cook than Dorothy Jones.
Man, if you need candlelight for, cornflakes, you're in big trouble.
Yes.
I can imagine someone turning out in late and saying, well, we have candles for breakfast and we have candles for lunch. What are they talking about? So what are you going to pick? Candlelight.
Candlelight.
Here she comes. Which do you consider more romantic, Patty? Moonlight, candlelight, firelight, or no light at all?
This is really a tough one. Oh. Firelight.
No, that's not what Larry said. Interesting. Tell her what you said, Larry.
I said you'd pick candlelight. Because... You're always lighting candles.
I know, but I prefer firelight. It's just wonderful.
Oh. Well, someplace... Heart. She's getting firelight someplace, Larry, and you'll have to check up and
yes,
find out where
it is.
I love it, Larry.
Because with you, it's candles. I don't know what's happening. Sorry about that, Patty.
I don't know who's lighting his candle.
Yeah, I don't care.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Oh, it's Patty we're talking to.
Well, oh, yeah. What will Ann say, Bill?
That Porky's a swinger, isn't she?
Hey, I'll tell you.
The one I don't like... The one of all your selections I don't like, Bert, is that no light at all bit. Because
oh.
I like to see what I'm doing and who I'm with. I mean, we were married 3 years before I stopped taking a flashlight to bed with me. I'd have still been doing it, but Ann fell in love with a flashlight.
Hey.
We had a heck of a time break.
Hey, I haven't had a bed check since I was in camp. Are you kidding?
But listen... With us once, I remember we were at a rustic country inn once, and I said, let's go up and take a bottle of wine and sit without anything on in front of the fireplace, because I burned my foot. Anyway, I know she'll remember that, because it was a big flop of a night.
It was.
How you doing, Porky?
Now she knows. Oh, she would have known, Bill. You should see the look on her face at this moment.
Anyway, got to be firelight.
Firelight it
if
is.
If it's not firelight, I'll never appear on this show again.
Oh, can we can't get the fix in, can we? Oh, don't say that. Here comes Ann. Oh, I hope she's right. Ann, which do you consider more romantic? Moonlight, candlelight, firelight, or no light at all?
It's difficult. I'll have to say what we have the most, and that would be candlelight.
No! Oh, no, that's not what he said. Well, Bill.
See?
Goodbye,
what's happened?
What is it, Bill?
You're always welcome.
He said
on
firelight
Price
and told us a story about burning his foot and said that that's what it had to be.
Uh-huh.
He was wrong.
I see.
But guess what? Dorothy, Joe, and Bob got the whole thing for the bananas at halftime. We'll change places. Step to the rear, fellas. We'll bring the ladies out front. We'll come back with the second half of Tattletales in just a moment. Don't go away.
I like the deal.
Three times and a whoosh of sound and whirling lights lets you know Cue Ball is thinking. Then Cue Ball answers, serious, irreverent, or just plain fun.
I'm stuck in this ball. I can't get out.
Cue Ball, only at the Sharper Image. Shop online at sharperimage.com. That's one word, sharperimage.com. Visit one of our Sharper Image stores or call 800-344-4444. That's 800-344-4444.
Inquisition. Sunday at 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific on Game Show Network.
And a heart fund group. We have the VSA with us today, which is a volunteer services to animals group, and a heart fund to the Sinai, Mount Sinai Hospital, who are here to raise money for their worthy causes, and that's terrific. Thank you. And Bob, you have a show coming up. You have the Pillsbury Bake Off, which is on August 31st, I believe, that everyone should know about and watch.
I hope they will, right here on CBS. And you'll be doing your thing here on Wednesday night at 8:30, won't you?
That's right, right here on CBS as well. That's terrific, though. I love that. That'll be fun. And I hope you watch us, too. Okay, if you're all ready, here we go. We'll get things rolling right away. $150 on this question, and this is it. Men, there are lots of jokes and cartoons about men undressing women with their eyes.
Hmm. But have you ever had the feeling that a woman was undressing you with her eyes? Yes or no? You ever had that feeling, fellas? Think it over. Off you go. See, I see their faces, you see. You don't get to see their faces when they hear the question. Patty, what will Larry say to this?
Because he's a modest person, he will say no. But
really?
That's not true. I have been with him on occasions where girls have done more than undress him. If you know what I mean.
With their eyes?
Yes, they have. Well, just with their eyes. That's it. That's it. That's
I'd pay $1.25 to see that, wouldn't you?
At least.
Okay, you're going to say absolutely yes.
Yes.
Here he comes. Oh, wait a minute. No?
No, I will clarify.
Yeah.
He'll say no, that girls don't undress him.
Oh, because he doesn't see it that way. But you do. So he'll say no. Okay, here he comes. Larry, have you ever had the feeling that a woman was undressing you with her eyes, yes or no?
Yes, Patty did it yesterday at Joseph Bank.
Well,
I can't believe it.
Not you, Larry. Don't you remember those other women?
Oh.
Now he does. Sorry, Larry. At this moment, about half the women in the red section are undressing you with their eyes.
With tar and feather.
Yeah, but with different intentions. Yes. Sorry about that, Larry. And what will Bill say?
I don't have the vaguest idea what he's going to say. Gosh, sometime in his life, I imagine someone must have wanted to undress Bill with his eyes, of course.
Okay.
He's going to say yes.
The answer is yes. Okay, here he comes. She meant her, you know that. Bill, have you ever had the feeling that a woman was undressing you with her eyes, yes or no?
Yes, Grace Kornbach.
That's it. You're right. There's more to the story. Bill, there was a yes, but there was more. What was the rest of that?
Grace Kornbach.
Grace Kornbach? Well, she was the girl that...
Well, when I was littler in school, I was littler than this, and I was in school, and Grace Kornbach used to always stand across the room in school looking over at me, and then she'd start to laugh, and I figured that's what made her laugh. Grace was a card. Yeah.
Of course, that doesn't happen anymore, does it? They don't laugh
anymore. They cry a little.
Yeah.
One girl up the street sent flowers about a week ago.
All right. Now, cut that out. Thank you, Bill. Dorothy Jo, what will Bob say?
Well, gosh.
I expect Don Wilson to pop in any minute.
Price is Right, when he gives him a car, they practically undress him anyway.
Period, yes.
Yeah. So I expect he'd say yes.
Okay, the answer is yes.
Yeah.
I'm sure it's yes. Here he comes. Bob, have you ever
Bert,
heard the... Yes.
Stop looking at me that way.
Oh, no. Do you know that yesterday someone actually asked if you guys could see out of those things? They really did.
I can see Cullen out of this ear.
Have you ever had the feeling that a woman wasn't dressing you with her eyes? Yes or no, Bob?
It's probably just wishful thinking, but yes.
That's right. She didn't say wishful thinking, though. You're right. Bob and Bill are right. They split it in half. Got a pretty good close game. We'll come back in a moment with our $300 question on that. We'll decide it. See you in a moment.
Which bag seals tighter, Glad or this Ziploc slider bag?
My Ziploc slider is tripping. Wait a minute.
My Glad is double locked.
The double lock green seal. Only Glad has it.
Can I borrow a cup of water?
Don't get mad. Get Glad.
This is my family. They're really busy people. Even Spot. We don't get to see each other as much as we'd like. That's why I instituted Family Game Night. It's a special night once a week when we all get together as a family. We play games like Monopoly and Scrabble. We laugh a lot. Being together like this, it's important. My family's just growing up so fast, and I want to be there for them.
Institute your own family game night with these great family games from Milton Bradley and Parker Brothers.
Family game night. It's just a good idea I had.
Just to be close to you, girl.
When words are not enough.
Turn off the lights. And let's get it.
Say it with body and soul.
Come on to me, baby. Like you never done before. Distant love, love.
Present. presenting the Body and Soul Collection, 24 love songs. Get Body and Soul on two CDs or two cassettes for just $19.99. Loving you gave me something. Order with your credit card and get a free album featuring Marvin Gaye. That's three albums of sensual music for $19.99. You'll hear great artists like Jeffrey Osborne, Luther Vandross, Freddie Jackson, Patti LaBelle. Then audition other Body and Soul albums. Satisfaction guaranteed.
I believe in miracles. Love's a miracle.
Remember, use your credit card and get three albums for just $19.99.
Call 1-800-837-3883 to order Body and Soul for only $19.99. Use your credit card and receive a free third album. That's 1-800-837-3883. Or send check or money order to Body and Soul, Department 4, Richmond, Virginia, 23280.
Isn't this fun? Okay, I just said this is fun because it is. Isn't aren't these people wonderful? They truly are. Here we go. Now. Well, I don't want to. I just said, aren't these people wonderful? And the audience applauded, but I noticed the bananas applause was a little stronger because Dorothy, Joe, and Bob were in the lead at the moment. But this will decide it, fellas. This is worth $300. Men, do any of the people you don't like know that you don't like them? Yes or no? Do any of the people you don't like know that you don't like them? Think it over. Off you go. Good question, Patty. What do you think Larry will say?
Me?
Yes,
already?
We'll start with you.
He will say, no, and it's true. Larry, no matter who it is, I mean, he likes them. It's very hard for him not to like someone. So I think he will honestly say, if no, right?
No. The people is, the question
I'm so
is,
confused.
Do any of the people,
it's my first show.
Do any of the people you don't like know that you don't like them, I'm saying to Larry?
No.
In other words,
they don't know.
He doesn't tell them.
Right.
I see. They don't know. Just one day they'll be walking down a street.
And
it'll be over. Okay, the answer is no, they don't know. Here he comes. Larry, do any of the people you don't know, I mean you don't like. Hi, Larry. Larry, do any of the people you don't like know that you don't like them? Yes or no?
This is our comeback, folks. Yes.
No, that's not what you said.
Your brother, Patty. Your brother.
That?
Your brother.
Your brother.
Does he know you don't like him?
Absolutely.
Oh, wonderful. I hope if you're watching
count.
Out there,
sweetheart,
it's Larry.
He doesn't count.
It doesn't count?
It doesn't count. No, he does. I can't believe you said
you're making
said
it
that.
Worse, Patty. Now you're saying your brother doesn't count.
No, he doesn't.
Sorry, because nobody likes him, Gene said.
Well, that
sorry
too.
Sorry about that, Larry. And what will Bill say to it?
Oh, yes.
Yes?
Oh, yes. A thick lip or something would signify to someone.
That he doesn't like.
Yeah, he does not hold those things in. There are a few people that he doesn't like that don't know that, but there are other people that
who know
that
it.
He does not like them.
Right, okay. Yes. Here he comes. The answer is yes. Bill, do any of the people you don't like know that you don't like them? Yes or no?
Yes.
That's correct. You got it.
I'm transparent. Yeah. Absolutely.
Absolutely right. That makes it kind of interesting because here we are down at the wire. This question will decide the game. Dorothy, Joe, if you get this right, you and Bob have it for the bananas. If not, Ann and Bill will come from behind and win it all. And the question is... Do any of the people that you don't like, I'm saying to Bob, know that he doesn't like them?
I think they know he hates them.
Oh. Well, that's even a little stronger than we put it on the card here, but we'll certainly accept that.
Okay.
The answer is yes. He tells them, eh?
Well, not just out. He doesn't just walk up and announce it, but he indicates it forcefully.
Right. Okay.
Yeah.
I understand. Isn't he working on...
on stuff to that would help him enact the way he feels?
It's a secret. Did he tell you?
No, no. I'm not even going to say anything about it then. Okay, the answer is yes, and this is for the game. Here he comes. Bob, do any of the people you don't like know that you don't like them, and this is for the game? If you get this one right, you got it for the bananas.
Yes, most of the people.
That's right. You got it. Go to Joe and Bob. Ann and Bill split the $300. However, time is upon us. The bananas have won it.
Let's hear it.
We shall return in just a moment and let you know how much the bananas have won, and it's good.
So you want to play some rock and roll? The first thing you need is a new style. Oh, and don't forget the music lessons. Of course, you could just tune in and play Rock and Roll Jeopardy on Game Show Network.
This game rocks.
Rock and Roll Jeopardy weekends at 12:30 p.m. Eastern, 9:30 a.m. Pacific on Game Show Network.
You're about to see a toothbrush do something rather unusual. Introducing the Colgate Navigator. It bends wide open, so its bristles gently adjust to your teeth for a thorough clean. The new Colgate Navigator, bent on cleaning better.
Actual size of hazelnut. Actual size of hazelnut flavor in Hazelnut Flavor Coffee Mate. The rich, creamy taste of Carnation Coffee Mate from Nestle. Flavor doesn't get any bigger.
Every month, college students eat 60 million slices of pizza. And they don't always have a toothbrush. Chew on this. Chewing Trident after meals can help prevent cavities from forming.
Good breakfast.
So when you can't brush, chew on this. Try.
Your face has over 20,000 pores. Make them look smaller, your skin smoother, more even, with new Neutrogena Pore Refining Cream. The daily moisturizer with retinol and alpha hydroxy. Neutrogena Pore Refining Cream. This was worth waiting for.
This is my family. They're really busy people. Even Spot. We don't get to see each other as much as we'd like. That's why I instituted Family Game Night. It's a special night once a week when we all get together as a family. We play games like Monopoly and Scrabble. We laugh a lot. Being together like this, it's important. My family's just growing up so fast, and I want to be there for them.
Institute your own Family Game Night with these great family games from Milton Bradley and Parker Brothers.
Family Game Night is just a good idea I had.
He never wrote a book. He never held an office. He never did any of the things that usually accompany greatness. Yet all the kings that ever reigned and all the governments that ever sat have not had so much impact as that single, solitary life. Now you can share the events of his remarkable ministry when you watch this free video, The Lamb of God. It's a gift from the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. This powerful video depicts events from the life of Jesus Christ as recorded in the King James Version of the Holy Bible. As you watch scenes of his birth, teaching, trial, death, and resurrection, you will better understand how his life can change your life. Call now for your free copy of The Lamb of God. It's a gift without cost or obligation from the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints.
Hey, watch this. No actors, no stunt doubles, no kidding. Extreme Gong is up next, followed by Beauty and the Beasts on Throat and Neck. Then three's a crowd.
Oh, well, there you are, for goodness sakes. The Bananas with Dorothy, Joe, and Bob won $425. We had $1,425. Big ones. Thank you all. You were splendid. And thank you for watching us on Tattle Tales. Bert Convy saying so long. See you next time.
This is Gene Wood speaking for Tattle Tales, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.